Good morning. Blessed one of the Most High God of Israel. Hallelujah. I come to give honor to the King of Kings and the King of the universe. And I desire to encourage you today. There may be something going on in your life and you may not quite understand, but I want to read from 2 Corinthians from King James. Hallelujah, about seeing that you have this ministry, seeing that you have a great call on your life, and seeing that you are misunderstood a lot. And the Father is the only one that really understands us at times. So we thank Him for being our strength and for giving us His wisdom and for giving us understanding and the knowledge of what He is doing. If you are a person that has a really special call, then you know that you are tested on every side. And you never know whom the Father will use to test you. So I'll read some from 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter, just to encourage you. It says here, therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not. We do not give up. It doesn't matter whether our husbands understand us or not, whether our children understand us or not, whether our sisters or our brothers understand us or not. We stand strong according to the faith that the Father has placed in us, and we faint not. We do not give up and we do not give out. Verse 2, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, not handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. When there's something on our hearts and our minds, we take it to our Heavenly Father and we remember that we are called and set aside by Him. We have been anointed by Him. He knows our heart and He knows the intent of our heart. Verse 3, and I'm reading from King James as it is. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, and whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is in the image of God, should shine unto them. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, has shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. And we call Him Yahushua HaMashiach. But I'm reading from the King James. But we have this treasure. Now you just think about your beautiful vessel. And just think about all the wonderful things that you have done. Not only for your family, for your children, for your family, but for those strangers that you do not know. Hallelujah. Because we have this treasured earthen vessels, which is the word of our living God of Israel. To be full of the word means that you have living waters in your heart so that those that are weary can get a long drink of cool water of righteousness. Hallelujah. Verse 7 again. But we have this treasured earthen vessels that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. For we which live are always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. So then death worketh in us, but life in you. we having the same spirit of faith according as it is written, I believe, and therefore have I spoken. We also believe, and therefore we speak. And I just thank our Heavenly Father for the fact that He has called each of us and He has chosen us. And we know that as He is promoting us or preparing us or increasing in our lives various responsibilities, and sometimes it reminds me of the potter and the clay, that sometimes we can be working a work, and unless we change our direction, we will continue to work that work 15, 10, 20 years. But then He allows something to come in our lives. Hallelujah. And He looks, the Father as the potter looks at His clay. And He says, you know what? I'm going to have to do something right here because I need the direction to change. I need to separate some of my people from each other. Sometimes He separates us through death. Hallelujah. Sometimes He separates us by one person moving to the other side of the world. And sometimes He just changes our heart and something comes up that would cause a separation. And so the potter takes the clay back down. Hallelujah. And He looks at His clay and He says, I'm going to shape this clay in a way where I can use it in another way. I want to expand what I've called him or her to do. And so the Heavenly Father take you down, you and me, and like the clay that we are, He molds and shapes us for such a time as this, so that we can be used as a counselor in the family, as a singer in the family, as the one that comes with the prophetic word in the family. You are unique in your own family and unique with the people that He has connected you with. Look around at the people that He has connected you with. Look around at your family. Which family member just absolutely get on your nerves? Which family member that is always there, hallelujah, when you have to share something? Which family member or friend that you can always go to no matter what? Father, put all these people in your life, some that trouble you and some that never trouble you, so that He, as the potter, can use the people to shape you into this new position before He promotes you. What I mean by that is before He open up your understanding and to let you know that He has expanded you. He will never let go of you, and He never gives up on you. He just don't want you to faint, and He don't want you to give out. No matter what anybody do, it's you and Father. And when it's you and Father, other people will come to know that His hand is up on you in a mighty way. Tehillim Psalm 139 says that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. So I just want to encourage you, continue to stand. Even though your sister or your brother may not show up when you want them to, or your friend may not be there when you want that friend to be there. But just know this, the God of Israel is the one with these mighty hands. He is the potter. We are the clay. So He's using our circumstances, our disappointments, our imaginative things that we sometimes have to shape us into what He wants us to be right now and this day. So continue to stand, hallelujah, knowing that the God that has purchased you through the blood of His Son, hallelujah, that we know is Jesus, Yeshua, Yahushua, in many other ways. So Father wants you to stand firm and let love is strong, is stronger than death. Love is why Messiah hung on that execution stake just for you. So let Father have His way. It's just another test that you're going through and that you're being tested so Father can let you know how excellent and how spiritually filled up you are with His word of righteousness. So continue to eat the bread of life. Continue to stand. You are special. And Father will not fail you. You will be persecuted. You will be lied about a whole lot of things. But don't let that stop you from the mighty work. You have a wonderful day. And I just want to say to all of my family and my relatives and my friends and Facebook, we pray for you faithfully every morning at 6 a.m. unless something happens and there's a day we may miss. But normally it's 6 a.m. and it's 8 p.m. every night unless something come up. We haven't missed too many of those, but you are on Father's mind. Increase your prayers because it's making a difference. Be of a good courage and understand that Father that has started a work in you will complete it. And you will live and you will not die until you have seen what Father promised you. Hallelujah. May you have a wonderful day and may Father's blessing be upon you. Just a minute. In the event that there's someone out there that have difficulties in their bodies, and it may be in your eyes, might be in your stomach, it might be your heart, or it might be any organ in your body, might be your kidneys or pancreas. I pray that Father will send his word, and I pray for healing for your body, for your heart, for your soul. I pray for those that are going through surgery today, that Father would also, hallelujah, be there with the doctors and guide those hands, and that he would anoint that place and there'll be no infection and that you'll heal up rapidly. I pray for, hallelujah, for your eyesight to, for Father to bless you with a better eyesight. And I bless him and thank him for touching your bones, touching your brain, touching your muscles and everything. And if I haven't named anything, I touch and agree with your prayers. If you have anything in your body, I do ask Father to forgive us of any sins that we have done, known and unknown, anything we should have done and didn't. I ask him to have mercy upon each one of us and pray that you have a wonderful day as we pray for salvation of souls and as we pray for revival to spread, continue to spread throughout the world. Hallelujah. Be blessed in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. And our reading came from King James. Shalom, everybody.